Hello, let's have a look at a simple Swing Java GUI application. Swing is a framework which is used to create Java GUI applications. Swing is a lightweight framework which is newer than the AWT. To create a Swing application, you need to import javax.swing package. There you have lots of user interface components such as JFrame, JPanel, JLabel, JTextField, JButton, so on. Also, along with the Swing package, you may need a Java AWT package, because to create a layout, this layout is defined in java.awt. Also, if you want to use any events, you need to import Java AWT events package. So, in this application, we are going to create one class. Swing Test is a Java class which is extended from JFrame. So, the Swing Test is a JFrame. So, what is JFrame in Java? JFrame is defined in Swing. So, what is that JFrame? JFrame is the equivalent for window. So, window will have a title bar, minimize, maximize, and close button, and then some content area. So, this is JFrame. So, we are going to create a window here. Swing Test is a window now. So, inside the window, we have constructor. So, this constructor is going to execute few lines of code, and inside this window we have also defined a label. We are going to add this label to the window. When we create a window, we can set some attributes such as size, width, and height. So here we are setting the size to 300 by 350, that is 300 is the width and 350 is the height. And if you want to center the window, in the window is small now, your screen is probably large. So in the screen, if you want to center the window, you can set location relative to null, so that will center your window. And you can set the closing operation. When window is closed, if you want to terminate entire application, you just say jframe.exitOnClose. There are many other options also available. You can try dispose, for instance. And now layout. How you want to lay out the components inside the window? Inside the window, where you want to place your component? If there is only one tiny component, you can center it. If you want to add more components, you can start from the corner and go on. If this width is not sufficient, you can place the component in the next line. So likewise, this is flow layout in Java. We are using flow layout. There are many other layouts also. You will see them soon. So we have created a label, new JLabel. We are creating a label object, and we are assigning this label object to L. So this is the text inside the label. Label is used to display simple text in JFrame. We have added the this add method is inside Swing Test. Swing Test is a frame, hence this add method is the method of JFrame. We are essentially adding this label L to the frame. After that, we are calling setVisible. SetVisible method, when it is invoked with the true as argument, your frame will be visible. Overall, we have created a JFrame, we have added a label, and we are making the frame visible. When all these things will be invoked? When Swing Test object is created. We will create Swing Test object in main method. New Swing Test. This will create a new object, and when new object is created, constructor is invoked, and all these operations will be executed. Window should be visible. We will just execute and try this. I will say javac swingtest.java. Compiled. Now I will say Java Swing Test. So this is our JFrame, and this is our JLabel, which says hello. Now I will, if I close this, so this window should be closed. Let's try maximizing this label will be in the center itself. I will restore. This is my original position. I will close. So This is about the simple swing application. If you want to improve, instead of just creating object in this way, you can use appropriate constructor for that. That is, you should use dispatch using swing utilities. Swing utilities is a framework which provides appropriate threading options for creating window. So this is a better way of creating your window. And let's also add a text field and button. Let's see how they are going to look. I will add a J text field and J button. Let's declare them here, and now we need to create them. So let's copy paste this text. So what we are going to do, text field is T, hence we will create a text field. T is equal to new J text field. I will paste it here. T is equal to new J text field. What should be the width? You can specify. 16 is the column width of the text field. Button B is equal to new J button. We are going to create a button. The text inside the button will be test. Now let me save it, and let me compile it once again. Java C swing test compiled. Now let us run it. Java swing test. So here we go. Hello is the label. This is text field having 16 column width, and next we have a J button. The caption is test. Okay, so let's compare the swing application with the AWT application. I have my AWT window here. This is AWT window. You compare, label looks bit similar, however this is bit bolder. Text field is looks bit dull here, however this is swing text field. Button, notice the difference between the this user interface components. Also if I close this window, nothing would happen. I have not set any close operation to this window. However, if I close, the application will be terminated. Thank you for watching. Happy learning.